All right, guys, in this video, we're going to be talking about arguments a little further. We were going to move on to keyword arguments, but before we do that, it's going to make more sense to cover default arguments first. So let's go ahead. I've cleared out my script here. I suggest you guys do the same just for repetition. I mean, you could remodel your current function to work with this. However, repetition is key to mastering something. So let's go ahead, drop down two lines, define a new function. We're going to name it print something. And it's going to take two parameters. One is going to be name, and the other is going to be age. Now let's open that with a colon and print out one string, which we're going to concatenate with name and age. So my name is name, and my age is age. Simple enough. Now we're going to go down here and call this function. And my age is going to be 27. I'm sure you guys already see a problem with this. So I'll give you props for that, because this is not going to work. And that's exactly why I'm showing you. We're going to run it, and it's going to say that it can't convert int object to a string. Now there's a few different resolutions to this. One I've already shown you. You can just wrap this in string. Now you can run it and it will work. Now this is why I mentioned this earlier, because you can definitely do this. However, what we're going to do is, instead of concatenating the string, we're going to remove all these extra characters. We're going to separate things by a comma. Going to remove the extra spaces around the text as well, because we don't need them, and you'll see why. Now this will work without converting this integer to a string, and the reason is because when we use commas, it just says print out. It just says print out these four things one after another. We don't need to concatenate different pieces of data. It's actually printing out a different number of things. So it's going to print this out as a string. It's going to print this out as a string because we're passing it in as a string. This is going to be printed out as a string, and this is going to be printed out as an integer. However, when I save it here and run it, you won't know the difference. See, it says my name is Nick and my age is 27. You don't notice that this is an int. So this is a perfectly acceptable way to do that. Now, what if I only wanted to pass it one argument? What we can do there is we can create default arguments. So actually, let's pass in Nick. So let's go ahead and change these to accommodate only passing in some of the values. So what we're going to do is set a default value. And how you do that is, inside the parameter list of the function, you're going to assign values to these variables. These are just variables that you're creating right here. So you can create a variable and assign a default name. And then same with age. You're going to assign a default age, which we're going to say is unknown. Now we're going to save it. Now when I run this, what we have here is my name is Nick and my age is unknown, because I'm only passing in this. So what happens is, you'd think, well, shouldn't name equal someone? It would if I didn't pass anything in. So we can do that as well. We're going to save this and run it, and it's going to say my name is someone and my age is unknown, because we're not passing in anything. However, we're going to pass in the first argument here, and this is going to take priority over this value here. This basically means this variable is going to be equal to someone if no value is passed in. Age is going to be equal to unknown if no value is passed in for it. So that's how to use default arguments in functions. In the next video, we're going to be talking about passing in specific parameters by using keyword arguments.